I'm Mitchell Hauser. I'm a senior at Sauhegan High School. I'm a running back and a middle linebacker. And you're watching Friday Night Football on Channel 9 News.
Thanks to Sauhegan senior Mitch Hauser for starting us off tonight. Welcome to another edition of Friday Night Football. This is week 6 already. I've got 14 games to show you tonight. Our first one is out east in Division 1, 5-0 Winnicunnett, and 4-1 Portsmouth. Let's get right to it. And here come the Clipper Cats in red, charging on to Tom Dobney Field. Winnicunnett loves the ground and pound. First drive, Owen Bateman busts one up the middle for 21 yards and a first down. So a strong start. The Warriors had the ball at the 3-yard line, but they coughed it up. They had 4 turnovers tonight, by the way. Connor Finland puts it on the ground, and Agnes Moss comes up with a big recovery for the Clipper Cats at the 1-yard line. But on their next possession, here comes Winnicunnett again, and this time Tucker McCain busted in from 3 yards out, 7-0 Warriors. That young man had a huge night, you'll see later. More good defense here, Will Hindle airs it out here. Winnicunnett's Dominic Gold comes flying into the last moment and knocks it away. Second quarter, another touchdown for one of the toughest running backs in the state, the senior McCain from 11 yards out. Winnicunnett remains undefeated, 21-6. How about this for McCann? 2 touchdowns, 160 yards, and 27 carries. Dover at Exeter, Green Wave are in the white. Second half, Damon Grace takes this one up the middle, breaks some tackles and fights his way to pay dirt. Touchdown Exeter. And bring on the kicker, Ethan Moss knocks it through. Change that 37-0 to 38-0. There we go. Dover has the ball near midfield. The pass by Spencer Ryan is deflected and picked off by Desmond Rugg. That's why they practiced the tip drills in practice a couple drives later. More defense from the Blue Hawks, Edward Perry. Pettit charges into the backfield and sacks the quarterback. 2 more points for Exeter here as the snap goes over the head of the punter and out of the end zone. Exeter with the shutout, 40-0 to Blue Hawks, 4-1. All right, Manchester Central and Concord in the Crimson Tide get the best of the Little Green. 35-12, Cody Rashad running for 2 scores. Jamari Arzu had 2 of his own, and Jackson Wakua had an INT. Ivrona Merrimack, getting the 35-28W, close one there. All right, Bishop Guerin and Nashua and North. Bishop Guerin up 7-6 in this second, but this is a huge play right here. There's a fumble, but the freshman, Luke Peters, scoops it up. And he's not going to let anybody ruin this moment for him. The freshman gets the touchdown, a huge one. Titans go up 12-7. The Cardinals march right back down the field, finishing this drive off with a run by the QB, Matt Sanatuccio. Cardinals up 13-12 in the third. This was a crazy play. Charlie Bellavance takes the handoff. It's a nice run, but he fumbles it. But it's about being at the right spot at the right time, and his teammate Adam Ganu is right there for the touchdown. The Titans trailing 26-19 in the fourth. This is a huge play. Nick DeJesse pulls in the pass. He isn't brought down, and he's gone. That made it 26-25, but Bishop Guerin holding on to this one, 26-25. The Cardinals now 5-1. Salem with a 34-22 W over Keene. The Blue Devils now 3-2. Aiden McDonald, I feel like I say his name every week. 3 scores. Damian Gigante had 1 as well. How about Goffstown and Spalding? The Grizzlies all over the Red Raiders, 35-6. Peyton Strickland and Caden Perry had 2 TDs. Josh Webb throwing for 3 TDs. And shout out to Rob Bugatti with his first career touchdown. Goffstown improving to 3-1. Take it to Division 4 now. Summersworth looking good early on at 3-1. Meanwhile, Fall Mountain hoping to get above 500 with the win tonight. Let's head to John Cooper Field. First drive. Jeff DeCorn to Tayshawn Shepherd for a long connection. Taken down around the 10-yard line. So a good setup right here. Next play is a handoff to Lucas Kelly, who gets in easily 8-0 Summersworth after the 2-point conversion. Look at the band, Fall Mountain with the ball. Now Luke Gay with the long pass to Brady Elliott. Just beautiful. He'll pull it in for the score. The Wildcats can't get it done on the 2-point conversion. 8-6 Toppers. Now down by 2, Fall Mountain needs to make a stop late in the first quarter. Jake DeCorn, he'll hand off to Calvin Lambert. He'll get in for the score, 14-6 after the failed 2-point conversion, and Summersworth now 4-1 after defeating Fall Mountain 34-6. All right, Interlakes at Stevens. Stevens up 16-12 in the second half. Mid-fourth, Stevens' Zach Bundy handing off to Jalik Ribeiro, who runs in for the score. The PAT is good, so 23-12 lead for Stevens. And after stopping Interlake, Stevens is back in scoring position. Another handoff to Jalik Ribeiro, who breaks a few tackles. Nice run right there for the young man. Makes it 30-12. Stevens going on to win this one 30-12. Aiden White did it all. Two catches, 117 yards and a touchdown. He also made a 22-yard field goal. Impressive.
How about Cougars?
All right, Conval, Laconia, third quarter. Laconia leading 35-0 and looking for more. Albert De Almeida gets the pitch and is running to the left side, but fumbles. Covered by Caden Tillman. Laconia doing all they can to keep the shutout. Hunter Coutier with a huge swat of the ball. Cougars would go three and out. Fans were pretty happy about this in the stands. But we take you late in the fourth quarter. Conval gets on the board. Jackson Salami runs into the left and changes directions. He takes it to the end zone. Laconia wins 35-6. Laconia improving to 3-3 with the 35-6 W. Drew Holzmer and Colton Roy combining for 225 yards and four touchdowns. Milford versus Hanover. The Spartans win it 34-7. That was the first loss of the season for Hanover, by the way, so they're both 5-1 now. Caden Zielinski had three TDs for Milford. How about Sanborn and Timberlane? The Owls 6-0, defeating Sanborn 47-14. Dom Capetta had a night running four and throwing for a touchdown.
Let's go!
How about St. Thomas and Kingswood? Opening drive for the Saints. Spencer Lesser with a hard run up the middle, gets into the red zone. The very next play, Liam Sullivan takes it to the house 14 yards out. 7-0 St. Thomas. Kingswood trying to get something going. Andrew Kinsitson with a quick pass to Aiden Brearley. He gets knocked out of bounds, but it was all Saints on this one. Tyler Liedberg with a 62-yard touchdown as well. Liam Sullivan and Liedberg coming up big for the Saints tonight. St. Thomas winning it 63-0. At Hillsborough Daring at Sauhegan at the Jungle. Sabres with the ball. Romy Jane with the pitch to J.J. Bryden. Little ankle breaker right there. He makes the first man miss, and then the rest of the defense misses. Touchdown, Sauhegan, 7-0 in the first. Bright rush for two touchdowns, by the way. Sabres ball again. The freshman, Romy Jane, takes the snap. He drops back. He knew where it was going the whole time, connecting with the wide-open Maddox McGrath. Sabres now up 13-0 in the first. Three touchdown passes for Jane. The Hillsborough defense making a play, though. Noah Carter with the sack, but too much Sabres. Sauhegan winning it 47-8.